Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Governor Livingston's annual King of Hearts competition. For those of you that don't know, this is a male beauty pageant, but for a good cause. Thank you. All proceeds go to the American Heart Association.
Thanks, Ian, and thanks for writing the script tonight.
No problem, Kayla.
Ian, have I ever mentioned how beautiful your eyes are?
Oh, please, you're flattering me. Anyway, let's get back to the King of Hearts competition.
First, we would like to introduce all of our competitors. The freshman competitors are Matt Nixon, Killian Quinn, Leo Campagna, and Tim Donahue. Our sophomore competitors tonight are Andrew Clark, Chris Kaylor, and Lucas Vitolo.
Our junior competitors tonight are Josh Quinn, Matt Ward, Kyle Brackman, and Ben Gillow. And last but not least, our senior competitors are Noah Marcus, Ryan Stalin, and Dylan Burns. Do you know, just leave this.
I sure wish you were competing, Ian. You have the physique of Channing Tatum coupled with the animal-like ferocity of Antonio Banderas.
Kayla, I thought I told you to stick to the script. Anyway, please put your love for me aside for now.
Our judges tonight are Marcella Martinez, Paige Benson, Katie Riley, Alessandra Henry, and Blair Wagner. Judges, please avoid looking at Ian St. Clair. His looks are intoxicating, and you will find yourself completely compelled to sail the Mediterranean with him.
Kayla, can you just focus? You know I'll be busy sailing around Curacao with Emma Watson this summer.
Only one can dream. Anyway, our escorts tonight are Amanda St. Clair, Katie Chiricella, Alexa Pantina, Emily Gaudet, Jen Leonard, Yili Wu, Colleen Frank, and Lauren Jankowski.
Now let's start the night off with some formal wear. Let's see how the guys dress up when they get their clubbing on.
Okay. First we have Killian Quinn and Katie Chiricella. Now we have Leo Campagna and Amanda St. Clair. Now we have Matt Nixon. Now we're going to ask Andrew Clark some questions. Andrew, describe your ideal date.
There's 365 days, so it's tough, but I'm going to say February 29th. It's kind of like when I talk to girls. It only happens once every 4 years, and most of the time they forget about it.
What's your idea of a perfect girl?
Call me traditional, but I'm really looking for a girl with at least 3 out of 4 limbs. But you know, I'm big on personality, so I'd be willing to take that down to 2.
What's your favorite hobby?
I really enjoy photobombing images of C-list celebrities. I also always carry candy in my pockets. Ah!
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
Animal. I've always kind of seen myself as a giant polar bear. But no, not the type in the wild that's like free and having fun. Like a polar bear in a zoo with a really small cage. And every time people went to look at me, I'd look into the fake Arctic background and look really sad and make them feel really bad.
Okay, last question. What are your plans for the future?
Well, I've always figured I had like a Benjamin Button type deal where I age backwards, but I always figured I could ride off of that, but in case that doesn't work, I could really see myself getting to the pageant business. I really want to take it to the professional level. I'm imagining myself starting a show on TLC. It's kind of a hybrid of The Bachelor and Toddlers and Tiara, where I live in a giant mansion with 27 little girls. And they all compete for pageant stardom.
Thank you, Andrew. That's it. Okay, now we're back to formal wear. Here comes Chris Kalor. Now we have Lucas Vitolo. Okay, now we have Tim Donahue. Okay, now we're gonna ask Tim some questions. Tim, describe your ideal date.
Well, I'm kind of, you know, a thrill freak, you know, so it'd have to be Bowcraft for me. That ride in the back, crazy, man. Ugh.
Okay. What's your idea of a perfect girl?
Well, I like girls who like me.
Okay. Yeah, okay. What's your favorite hobby?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious, isn't it? Pumping iron, ladies, yeah.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
A manatee. Manly, Timmy, get it? Come on, that's hilarious, guys. Come on.
Okay, last question. What are your plans for the future?
Well, my future is pretty clear. I think it's gonna have to be going to Harvard, studying Renaissance fashion, and then, you know, moving back in with my parents in the basement.
Great. All right, thank you, Tim. Okay, now we're gonna get back to formal wear again. Now we have Josh Quinn. Now we have Matt Ward. Okay, now we're going to ask Matt some questions. Matt, describe your ideal date.
Well, you know, I'd pick up the girl, bring her back to my house, go into my room, we'd close the door, turn out the lights, get under the covers, get nice and cozy and watch some Netflix.
What's your idea of a perfect girl?
These judges right here are the perfect girl.
What's your favorite hobby?
Well, on Sundays, me and my mom, we take a knitting class. And then after, we always get brunch. And, hold on. I did you a heart.
Thank you. Last question, what are your plans for the future?
You see, I don't plan for the future. I live in the now. Spontaneous. Unexpected. Pizzazz. Yeah. Right.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, now we have more formal wear. Here comes Kyle Brackman. Now we have Ben Gillo. Okay, here comes Noah Marcus. Okay, now we're gonna ask Noah some questions. Noah, describe your ideal date.
Well, I'm glad you asked. First I would pick her up from the playground.
Mom, you can't be here. You can't be here.
No, I'm gonna be here.
embarrassed us for the last 2 years. Your father and I do not want your name tarnished anymore.
What are you gonna do? Answer my questions for me?
Yes. What was the question, dear?
Describe your ideal date.
No.
Know what, Mom?
You're too young to date. We just got you your Bookface account, for God's sakes. Next question.
What's your idea of a perfect girl?
Oh, a perfect girl? She'd be Jewish, of course. Or at least her mother.
You can't say that, Mom. That's too offensive.
No. Offensive? How is that offensive? Is it offensive when Moses parted the Red Sea?
What does that even mean?
Next question.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
Can you let me answer one question, Mom? If I were an animal in the wild, I would be Justin Bieber. Because he's not just an animal. He's a party animal.
You know what? That's not even an animal. Next question.
What are your plans for the future?
Well, God willing, he'll get into some of the best colleges that he applied to. And my bubala, he could do anything. He could be a lawyer, he could be a doctor, he could be a lawyer.
Next question. Okay, now we have Ryan Stalin. Let's see how these guys look when they work out. Okay, first we have Ben Gillo. Okay, now we're gonna ask Lucas some questions. Lucas, describe your ideal date.
My ideal date, on a fishing boat right after a BP oil spill. The scent of oil really sets the mood, so.
Nice. What's your idea of a perfect girl?
No preference, anything I can get my hands on.
Okay. What's your favorite hobby?
Selling verb.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
I would be a tiger because they're fierce.
Okay. What are your plans for the future?
To become a royal ambassador of Emma.
Nice. Okay. Thank you, Lucas. Okay, now we have Matt Ward. Matt Ward. Now we have Kyle Brackman. Okay, now we're gonna ask Kyle some questions. Describe your ideal date.
Any date that starts on Craigslist is a pretty good date for me.
What's your idea of a perfect girl?
Any girl with less leg hair than I.
What's your favorite hobby?
I like to do a lot of things, but I'm pretty much just like chill with the local vermin, like mice and field rats and stuff.
What are your plans for the future?
I see myself being like a really good stepdad.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
I'd be a banana slug because they're both a boy and a girl at the same time, and that seems pretty cool.
Okay, that's it. Okay, thanks.
Now we have Ryan Stalin. Now we have Andrew Clark. Now we have Chris Kaylor. Okay, now we're gonna ask Chris some questions. Chris, describe your ideal date.
A nice, perfect, romantic candlelit dinner at McDonald's.
Okay, what's your idea of a perfect girl?
She has to have nice eyes, good personality, my height, and most importantly, must be able to bench all of my weight.
Okay. What's your favorite hobby?
Not jogging.
Okay. If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
A narwhal, because they're very rare, majestic, and beautiful.
What are your plans for the future?
I think I can milk another 3 years out of high school.
Okay. Thank you, Chris. Okay, now we have Noah Marcus. Okay, now we have Josh Quinn. Okay, and now we have Leah Campagna. Okay, now we're gonna ask Leo some questions. Leo, describe your ideal date.
My ideal date would be going to my basement, dimming down the lights, popping in Call of Duty, and playing all night long.
Okay. What's your idea of a perfect girl?
A perfect girl for me would be someone that I can talk to, I can have a conversation with, and that doesn't bother me most of the time.
Okay. What's your favorite hobby?
My favorite hobby, most of you know this if you know me, would have to be sleeping.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
I would be a panda. Why? Because of Kung Fu Panda.
Okay. What are your plans for the future?
My plans for the future are to stay here a couple more years, learn the teachers, and make them hate me.
Okay. That's all. Thank you. Okay, now we have Tim Donahue. Every day I'm shuffling. Okay, now we have Killian Quinn.
Shuffling, shuffling. Step up fast and be first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad, I'll stop.
Okay, now we're gonna ask Killian some questions. Killian, describe your ideal date.
So the girl says yes to the date?
Yes.
Alright, so I go to the girl, right? I ask her on a date and she doesn't pepper spray me.
Okay. Okay.
I don't think I'll ever get that far. I guess maybe take it to a movie or something. I'll let you know if I get that.
Okay, let me know. What's your idea of a perfect girl?
Well, first, I'd want her name to be kind of exotic. Like, maybe start with a K, like my name, because we'd have that in common. Like, maybe like cat something. I'd want her to be able to come from like a poorer background, so she'd be kind of humble. Maybe like be able to like hunt or like have a bow and arrow. I love a girl who can shoot a bow and arrow. Like, her bow and arrow skills would be good enough to win a battle to the death in an arena. And now that I think about it, I'm gonna go with Katniss Everdeen, and I need to rethink my life.
Okay. What's your favorite hobby?
My favorite hobby is a bit difficult to do because I kind of have to be alone for it, like in my house. But I like to jam out to T-Swift songs in my room while dancing.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
I'm not quite sure, but I'll tell you one thing. I would not be a giraffe. I got this weird thing with giraffes, man. I don't like their necks.
Okay. What are your plans for the future?
I think I'm probably gonna go home, take a shower. I'm pretty hungry, I'm gonna eat. I got some math homework. I gotta finish that up. But I think I'm gonna go to bed after that.
Sounds good. Okay, thank you. Okay, now we have Matt Nixon. And here comes Dylan Burns. These boys look in their swimwear. First up is Leo Campagna. Okay, next is Ryan Stalin. Ryan, describe your ideal date.
Well, I'd probably take him down to Paul's Meat Shack on Route 22. Best burgers in town.
Okay, what's your idea of a perfect girl?
Well, this one's a little special. So I like brunettes. I like them to have a big heart. I want them to be a future dad like me. But there's only one person out there that fulfills all that. Dylan Burns, will you go to prom with me?
All right. Okay. What's your favorite hobby?
Well, on the weekends, I like to dress up as a penguin and waddle around town.
Nice. If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
Well, I think that one's pretty obvious. I'd be the moose from Open Season 2. I mean, do I need an explanation?
No. I guess not. What are your plans for the future?
Well, I'm looking to settle down, you know, meet another person to spend the rest of my life with, and my number one mission, become a dad.
Nice. Okay. That's it, thank you. Okay, now we have Noah Marcus for swimwear. We're still doing swimwear. Okay, now we have Andrew Clark. And now we have Matt Nixon. Okay, Okay, now we're gonna ask Matt some questions. Describe your ideal date.
I would say, I would say maybe just chill, catch up on some Pretty Little Liars or Teen Mom.
Nice. Okay, what's your idea of a perfect girl?
Taylor Swift.
What's your favorite hobby?
Toning my glutes.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
I think I'd be a cat.
Why?
Because I am sassy.
Okay. What are your plans for the future?
Think be a billionaire rock star and move to Florida, or just sleep a lot.
Okay, that's it. Thank you. Okay, now we have Killian Quinn for swimwear. Now we have Lucas Vitolo. And now we have Ben Gillo. Now we're gonna ask Ben questions. Ben, describe your ideal date.
Taking my nice lady friend to a nice restaurant like the GL cafeteria.
Okay, what's your idea of a perfect girl?
Strong, independent man that don't need no man other than me.
What's your favorite hobby?
Taking long walks in the park by myself.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
I'd be a turtle because I'm a shell guy.
What are your plans for the future?
Being a Pokemon master.
Good, okay. Thank you, Ben. Okay, now we have more swimwear. Here comes Matt Ward.
I'm sexy and I know it. I'm sexy and I know it.
Now we have Chris Kaylor.
Check it out.
Okay, now we have Josh Quinn. Okay, now we're gonna ask Josh some questions. Josh, describe your ideal date.
Well, I'm not sure how my ideal day would start exactly. Maybe we'd go ice skating, or maybe we'd just watch a movie like Captain America. But either way, it would always end in the same place, my bedroom, where we could cuddle up and watch Pretty Little Liars on Netflix.
Okay, what's your idea of a perfect girl?
Well, to me, every girl is a perfect girl. But if I had to pick one quality that stood up above the rest, my perfect girl would probably be a judge at a male beauty pageant that raises money for the American Heart Association.
What's your favorite hobby?
Well, of course, I love baking heart-shaped cookies and cuddling and eating ice cream. But my favorite hobby would probably have to be volunteering at the animal shelter where I help out with underprivileged puppies.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
Well, that depends. What's your favorite animal?
What's your favorite animal? Yeah, you gotta say it. Say your favorite animal.
Puppy.
Oh, cute, okay. What are your plans for the future?
Well, I've decided to follow my childhood dreams and be either the president, a superhero, or a dinosaur.
Okay. Thanks, Josh. Okay, now we have Tim Donahue.
There was a time I used to look into my father's eyes. In a happy home, I was a king, I had a golden throne. Those days are gone.
Okay, now we have Kyle Brackman.
Memories on the wall.
Colleen Frank.
I hear the song from the places where I was born.
Okay, now we have Dylan Burns. Okay, now we're gonna ask Dylan some questions. Dylan, describe your ideal date.
My ideal date would be getting a mannequin from a mannequin auction, bringing it to me with the mall. Dressing it up in all kind of wacky outfits, and then afterwards bringing it to a nice Dairy Queen for lunch.
Okay. What's your favorite hobby? What's your idea of a perfect girl?
My idea of a perfect girl would be a Johnny Depp doppelganger, but one with longer hair and less facial hair.
What's your favorite hobby?
My favorite hobby is collecting scarves, vinyl records, and fedoras.
If you were an animal in the wild, what kind of animal would you be and why?
A dog with a blog or a kangaroo jack because they pack a very powerful punch.
What are your plans for the future?
My plans for the future are creating a nice piece of technological equipment called the iDad. It's kind of like an iPad, except it comes equipped with all types of great tips to be a nice dad.
Great, thank you, Dill. Okay, moving on from here, we're going to enter the talent section of the competition. Let's see what makes these guys more than just a pretty face. First, we have Leo Campagna.
Hi. So, for my talent, which isn't really a talent, because I'm a nerd, so I do magic in my spare time. So, I need a volunteer from the audience, and I'm going to go in the audience, because I can't see with all the lights in my face. So, please raise your hand. I'm taking you. Yeah, you. Take your time. No need for a rushing. That concludes your name of Jetson. All right, I'm gonna call you Jetson. So Jetson, hold the mic.
You awkward? Not awkward? You're about to be. All right. So it's a brand new deck.
Magic isn't real.
We got a non-believer here. All right, as for you folks, non-believer. He could talk smack, but he can't shuffle a deck. Okay, anytime you're ready. All right.
Hold the mic again. So choose a card, any card, the old cliche. Show it to the audience, I don't care. That's enough time. All right.
It's a king of hearts. I'm kidding.
Clever word on play. So, for all you people that didn't see it, this is the card. Don't tell me, or else you'll ruin the trick.
You can't see it.
All right, whatever. So I'm mixing your card into the deck. I know you don't believe in magic, but who knows? So
I do. It's fake.
You can still talk Mac, but you still can't shuffle a deck. So watch.
So we got Jetson over here, a non-believer, right? So watch this. All right, new draw to simmer down, calm yourselves.
Hold this. My lovely assistant. So watch, with the snap of the fingers, right? This is your card right here. That is not your card. You sure?
Pretty sure.
All right, well, let's try this again. I snap my fingers, right? The bottom card is your card.
No.
That one.
Nope.
Okay.
You're awful.
Thank you. So, I'm going to show you one more card. Is this your card?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to give you a second chance.
No, you give you a seventh chance.
Oh, okay. All right, so I'm going to give you a second chance. Are you sure this isn't your card?
Yeah.
You sure this isn't your card at all?
How many times do I have to say no?
As many times as I desire. You sure these two are in your card?
No.
Well, make a fist. Make a fist. I'm gonna put this right in here and hold it tight. Don't be weak. All right? So, I'm gonna smack the cards out of your hand. Look at that card and tell me if that's your card.
That is my card.
Now be a deer and pick up my cards. Well, thanks for all the help.
Okay. Thank you, Leo and Jensen. Okay, now we have Matt Nixon.
Hello. I'm not nervous. Okay, so I have come up with some pretty terrible pickup lines. I'm going to need a very lovely escort that I can demonstrate them on. Are you a parking ticket? Because you've gotten fine written all over you. You're lacking a very essential vitamin. Vitamin B. Are you a 90 degree angle? Because you're looking right. That's it. Okay. So, I feel it is my job in this world to make it a better place. So here are 14 ways to make the world better. Number one, put shelter hat. Start over. Put shelter animals in tiny hats to increase adoption. Make googly eyes standard on more products. Also mustaches. Institute a national walk like a velociraptor day. Get Snoop Dogg to open up a soup kitchen called Soup Doggy Dog. Also, get Robert Downey Jr. to open up a bakery called Robert Brownie Jr.'s. If we can't get rid of telemarketers, make them talk like pirates. Let's see. Number 8, call free refills, free fills. Just more fun. This is one for like school and the school administrators, wherever you are. Let kids reward themselves for getting up early by letting them go back to sleep.
I was gonna say, don't be a jerk. Really, don't be a jerk. It's annoying. Petition Cat Fancy Magazine to do a swimsuit issue. Print jokes on like parking and speeding tickets just to soften the blow. Then, the last way to make the world a better place is two words: panda police.
Okay, thank you, Matt. Now we have Tim Donahue.
Hey, how are you? Microphones, cool, okay. Love you too, babe. All my life, I knew I wanted to be a motivational speaker. Well, let's start it off a little bit further back. All my life, I knew I wanted to be on King of Hearts. You know, when I was 12 years old, I had my first words, King of Hearts. I live and breathe King of Hearts. In no way I was discouraged to come on stage in front of an audience in a bathing suit to be judged. So you're right, I made it here today to King of Hearts. But what? What is my talent? Yes, I know you asked. Well, I have a lot of talents. I can speak four languages, juggle with my feet, time travel, and bend the fabric of reality, but who can't? So, I ask myself, when you see me, what do you think? Handsome, maybe? Gorgeous? Hilarious? Intelligent? Gorgeous? Very gorgeous? Yes! Yes! Exactly! So yes, I agree with you, but the real key word is successful. That's right, I'm successful. I mean, look at me, I got all a man needs. A $200 haircut, a rockin' six pack, and another third thing that I cannot come up with. Well, you're right, I'm successful, and I'm the greatest, single most greatest motivational speaker of all time, yes. This is great. So, moving along, I have a little activity to warm us all up. So, look to the person to your left and right and say this. I like you. You're beautiful. Please. Talk about spirit, GL. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. My voice cracks. So I'm glad you guys all did that. Participation? Yeah, okay. Moving along. So, someone walked up to me recently and asked me, Tim Donahue, the almighty Tim Donahue, how can I too become a motivational speaker like you? And the real answer is, you can't. That's my job. You can't do this. But the answer that I gave them is we all can be motivational speakers if we set our minds to it. You can be a motivational speaker. You can be a motivational speaker. Mrs. Gerstner, vice principal of today, motivational speaker of tomorrow. Well, now I have another activity that we need us all to partake in. Everybody needs to stand up, please. Please, if you don't, join me. Join me in the sunlight! Yes! Great. Wow, isn't this phenomenal? Let's all put our fists together in our heart. And let's say, I am a butterfly!
I'm a butterfly!
In unison now, ladies and gentlemen, I am a butterfly!
I'm a butterfly!
One more time. But let's just reach into our soul. And find that spark. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I am a butterfly. Yeah, that's awesome. Okay, that's really cool. Sit down, we don't need you anymore. You're good. Now, to finish, I have a quote. Excuse me. I need to pull out my quote here.
Oh, don't get on with it!
You're really hurting my feelings, please. I'm putting myself out there in a public place and you're just really putting me down. Thank you. Yeah! Shutting down a heckler, am I right? Yeah! Okay, to finish, I have a quote. Now, I do not remember who said this quote, but I'm sure this woman grew up to be very stable and successful in life, very stable. And the quote reads, "There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, but sometimes I'm gonna have to lose." Yes, reach deep into your soul. What? Whoa, it's Tim Donahue from the future.
You betcha. Oh,
I have so many questions to ask you. Like, do I get into Harvard?
Full ride.
Yeah, whoa, yeah. Okay, man, I mean, what else were you gonna expect?
Seriously, younger Tim, quickly. We have to move into the time nether, quick, before the super android monkeys rise again. Take this lightsaber.
Let's grind, buddy!
Okay. Okay, Okay, now we have Lucas Vitola.
I've never seen a diamond in the flesh. I cut my teeth on wedding rings in the movies, and I'm not proud of my address. In a torn up town, and no postcode envy, but every song's like gold teeth, gray goose, dripping in the bathroom, bloodstained ball cap, trash in the hotel room. In our dreams, but everybody's like crystal Maybachs, diamonds on your timepiece, jet chains, islands, tigers on a gold leash. We don't care. We are caught up in your love affair, and we'll never be royals, royals. It's the one in our love. That kind of luck just ain't for us. We crave a different kind of buzz. Let me be your ruler, ruler. You can call me Queen Bee. Let me live that fantasy. My friends and I have cracked the code. We count our dollars on the train to the party, and everyone, not one who knows us knows that we're fine like this. We didn't come for money, but every song's like gold teeth, brain moves, tripping in the bathroom, bloodstains, ball gowns, trash in the hotel room. We don't care. We're driving Cadillacs in our dreams, but everybody's like gold, crystal Maybach, stars on a timepiece, jet planes, islands, tigers on a gold leash. We don't care. We are caught up in your love affair, and we'll never be royals, royals. It's a one and only. For us, we crave a different kind of buzz. Let me be your ruler, ruler. You can call me creepy, and baby, I rule. Let me live that fantasy. Oh, oh, oh. Life is great without a care. We are caught up in your love affair. Oh. And I'm in love with being queen, and we'll never be royals, royals. It's the one in our love. That kind of luck's just ain't for us. We craves different kind of buzz. Let me be your ruler, ruler. You can call me Queen Bee, and baby, I'll rule, I rule, I rule, I rule.
Let me live that fantasy.
Okay, now we have Andrew Clark.
Hello, everyone. My name is Andrew Clark, and I'm an identical twin. If you haven't realized this by now, you might want to see a doctor, but hey, who am I to diagnose you? So, anyway, every year, every month, every week, every day, I'm asked the same questions over and over again. So I'm here to answer a couple of those questions, so maybe I can have, like, at least 24 hours where nobody asks me anything. So first up, when I meet someone, they always go, hey, you guys are twins. Oh, do you feel each other's pain? Now, come on, that's ridiculous. Okay, that was a weird coincidence. Oh, she's leaving. Okay. So another one I get a lot is, hey, how do you tell the difference between you two? Well, you know, we're two different people. I use that one a lot. But also, I'm clearly the better looking one. But if that doesn't work, I'm also really good at bribing the judges. Judges, look under your seats. One of you want to read that out loud? I'll get on that, okay? I'll get on that. So another one I get a lot is they say, hey, you're a twin. Which one's the good twin and which one's the evil twin? Now, come on, this isn't a low-budget horror film. This wouldn't make sense. There's no such thing as a good and evil twin, and if one more person asks me that question, I'm gonna find where you live, and I'm gonna watch where you sleep. So this is the worst one. Every time I meet someone, they always go, hey, you guys are twins. Do you ever like play hilarious pranks and switch places? Now come on, everyone would be able to tell, and it wouldn't even be remotely funny. Like if I did it at a talent show, no one would laugh. But all this standing is hurting my feet, so I'm gonna go grab a chair.
So, the next question I always get is, do you ever forget which twin you are? I know you always see that happen in TV shows and movies, but the truth is, I always know that I am Andrew, and I will always be Andrew. Oh, I'm Andrew!
Hey!
I'm Will, actually, just saying.
Okay, now we have Chris Kaler. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking out those images. Quick shot, good strut walking, a little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby's for the game. Nope, nope, y'all can't copy up. Bad, moonwalking, and this here is a party. My posse's been on Broadway, and we did it all way. Chrome music, I shed my skin and put my bones into everything I record to it. And yet I'm on, let that stage light go and shine on down. Soup game and Plinko in my style. Money, stay on my craft and stick around for those pals. And now we have Ben Gillo.
Oh, yeah. All the single ladies, all the single ladies, all the single ladies, all the single ladies. Now put your hands up. If you like it, then you should put a ring on it. If you like it, then you should put a ring on it. Don't be mad at see another man wanted. If you like it, then you should put a ring on. If you like it, then you should have put a ring on. If you like it, then you should have put a ring on. Yeah.
Now we have Josh Quinn and Killian Quinn doing something together. Oh, now we have Matt Ward.
Matt Ward! Yes! We got the sex!
$20 in my pocket. I'm looking for a come up. This is being so
weird. Walk into the club like, what up? I got a big. I'm just pumped. I bought some from a thrift shop. Ice on the fringe is so damn frosty. The people like,
damn, that's a cold ass honky.
Rolling in hella deep, headed to the mezzanine. Dressed in all pink, set my gator shoes. Those are green drapes and a leopard mink. Girl standing next to me. Probably should have washed this. Smells like R. Kelly sheets. But it was 99 cents. Copping it, washing it. About to go and get some compliments. Passing up on those moccasins. Someone else has been walking in. Bummy and grungy. Fucking man, I am stunting and flossing and saving my money. And I'm hella happy that's a bargain. Oh, I'ma take your grandpa style. I'ma take your grandpa style. No, for real. Ask your grandpa, can I have his hand me down? Your Lord jumpsuit and some house slippers. Dookie Brown leather jacket that I found. Dig it. They had a broken keyboard. I bought a broken keyboard. I bought a ski blanket. Then I bought a kneeboard. Hello, hello, my ace man, my Miller. John Wayne ain't got nothing on my fringe game, hell no. I could take some pro wings, make them cool, sell those. The sneakerhead to be like,
ah, he got the Velcro.
I'm gonna pop some tags, only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is being awesome.
Ow.
I'm gonna pop some tags, only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is awesome.
What she know about rocking a wolf on your noggin? What she knowin' about wearing a fur fox skin? Whoa. I'm digging, I'm searching right through that luggage. One man's trash, that's another man's come up. Whoa. Thank your granddad for donating that plaid button up shirt. Cause right now I'm up in her stunt. I'm at the Goodwill, you can find me in the. I'm not stuck on searching in the section. Your grandma, your auntie, your mama, your mammy. I'll take those flannel zebra jammies secondhand and rock that.
Whoa.
The built-in onesie with the socks on them.
Whoa.
I hit the party and they stop in that.
Whoa.
They be like, oh, that Gucci, that's hella tight. I'm like, yo, that's $50 for a t-shirt. Limited edition, let's do some simple edition. $50 for a t-shirt, that's just some ignorant. I call that getting swindled and pimped. I call that getting tricked by business. That shirt's hella dope. And having the same one as six other people in this club is a hella don't beat gang. Come take a look through my telescope. Trying to get girls from a brand. Man, you hella won't. Man, you hella won't.
Goodwill. Popping tags. Yeah.
I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is being awesome. I'll wear your granddad's clothes. I look incredible. I'm in this big air coat from that thrift shop down the road. I'll wear your granddad's clothes.
Damn right.
I look incredible.
Hey, come on, man.
I'm in this big air coat from that thrift shop down the road. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm looking for a cover. This is being awesome.
Thank you, Matt. Now we have Josh Quinn and Killian Quinn.
All right, we're gonna do a tribute to the Blues Brothers.
Yeah!
coming to ya on a dusty road. Good loving, I got a truckload. And when you get it, you got something. So don't worry, cause I'm coming. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. Got what I got the hard way, and I'll make better each and every day. So honey, don't you fret, cause you ain't seen nothing yet. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man. Well, I'll grab a rope and I'll pull you in. Give you hope and be your only boyfriend.
Yeah,
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 yeah.
Okay, now we have Kyle Brackman. Do you need the microphone?
Got to say what I'm doing?
Now we have Ryan Stalin.
Good.
There we go. Good evening. So I'd like to thank everyone for coming out here. It's a special night tonight. We're raising a lot of money. But I don't want you to forget that there's kind of a history here. We've had a bunch of kids years past do this. And one that stuck out in my mind was Nick Ragazzo. Nick Ragazzo came on stage and he chugged a bottle of hot sauce. So Nick Ragazzo, son of Bob Ragazzo. Bob Ragazzo. He kind of puked backstage. So this one is in honor of him. I will be doing the gallon challenge.
I will, so you talked about this for like an hour today. No.
Come on. Okay. So I guess I won't be doing the gallon challenge. Let me think. I got it. How about I'll tell my favorite jokes from Family Guy. So you guys must know Family Guy, but I'll still give a little bit of background for those that don't. So there's this one episode where like Peter's been gaining a lot of weight, and you know Peter, he's like the big guy. He's already like big, but like they say that he gained weight. You can't really see it, but they say that he did, so you gotta believe it. So Peter walks into the room, and then Brian's the dog. Brian's like, he can talk, but like no one really thinks that's a thing. Like everyone's just okay with that. I don't know, I would be kind of freaked out. Whatever. So there's a talking dog. So Brian, the talking dog, talks to Peter, and he's like, hey, Peter, you've been gaining a lot of weight. I mean, that's not actually what he says, but like, he says that, and then Peter says, I mean, Peter's got that accent. He's like got the Boston, he says like car, like ka. I can't do it, so I won't say it. But the other thing is like, you know Stewie's the baby. I mean, that's another thing. Stewie can talk, but like no one really talks about it. Like he can talk, but only to certain people. Like he can talk to Brian, but not, I mean, it just really doesn't make sense. And his accent is British and no one on the show is British. It just doesn't make sense to me. And Family Guy. Stewie's not even there. So Brian's like, hey, Peter, you've been gaining a lot of weight. And then Peter, like in his accent, just goes like, I'm not gonna do the accent because like I said, I can't do it. He's like, no, I'm not. And then Brian's like, yeah, you are. And he's like, you want me to prove it? And then Peter's like, yeah, sure. So then Brian like reaches behind him. Like he doesn't have pockets, but he's still like, he has like an apple behind him. And then he like takes the apple out and he puts it next to him and it starts going around him. That doesn't really make sense. Like he's clearly not that big, but like the apple is like orbiting him. And the joke is that like he's like really, really, really big and he's gaining a lot of weight so that, you guys get that was the joke. That's pretty much one of my favorite jokes from Family Guy. I really don't know what else to say. How about this? I'll do it backstage. Cost is $20 admission. You can see me. Okay, whatever. I'm still gonna do it. So I guess I'm pretty much done here. I would do a mic drop, but apparently these things are expensive, so I'm just gonna. Sorry. I also need to put this stuff away. So could I like have some? Hey. Yeah. Just. No. Just go. No, do you want me to walk down? Here. No, I don't want to fall off. No, we'll go this. I'm okay. Thank you. Gallon challenge after school. Be there.
Okay, now Noah Marcus is gonna go.
Let's go, Noah!
Prepare yourself.
Macarena, que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Dala tu cuerpo alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Dala tu cuerpo alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Dala tu cuerpo alegría, Macarena. Macarena.
Called a soldier boy. You just gotta punch, then crank back three times from left to right. Why me crank it, why me roll? Why me crank that soldier boy, that Superman that hold out? Why me you crank that soldier boy? Why me you crank that soldier boy? Why me you crank that soldier boy? Why me you crank that soldier boy?
someone gonna grab the dumbbell? Probably got it. I don't know.
I'm sorry. We did not rehearse this part. We lost one.
Okay, for our final performance, we have Dylan Burns.
Okay, everyone, that's the end of the competition. But thank you. Let's give the judges a minute or two to tally up the scores and find out this year's winners of King of Hearts.
There's nothing in this world I wouldn't.
Thank you for waiting. We're sorry for the delay. Anyway, let's bring out all of our contestants for this year's 2014 King of Hearts.
Quinn. Okay. The sophomore king is Andrew Clark. Okay, the junior is Matt Ward. Our senior king is Noah Marcus. And our overall King of Hearts is Dylan Burns. Okay, wait. Shh. Okay, and then we don't have a crown, but we also have a Queen of Hearts, Mrs. Marcus. Supporting a good cause, put some queso in it. Thank you. Have a good night, everyone.